Under the radar, a group of audio magicians slid down the bloodlines of Africa into the undersea level sections of the city of LA. They hit the ground running, flowing musical anthems to uplift this generation of mentally discombobulated African American urbanites. This congregation of germinal musicians formed the association called UGMAA, Underground Musicians Association. The seed of this uplifting organization was the genius musical arranger Horace Tapscott. From within the chambers of his noble head emerged opulent runs of audible colors that elevated the thought processes of his audiences. The musicians who heard his call and came running to his side were in reality a band of angels sent to the Watts Happy Coffee House in the underbelly of LA by God to infuse the minds of Africans, captives of America, with the understanding of their own genetic magic and how it is inseparably hooked up to Mother Africa. The Ugmian, who was the embodiment of Mother Africa, was a regal looking, large lady with alluring eyes, Linda Hill. Her love for her people inspired anybody wanting enough to be near her dazzling activity. But the star, the rhythmic foundation of Ugma, was set in stone by the redoubtable David Bryant, the dynamic bassist whose astute hands gave voice to the intense rhythms that define the dimensions of the music. There were unbelievable times when David was joined by another way out bass player named Walter Savage, a man whose fingers walked up and down his bass as easily as a spider traveling effortlessly on the rungs of its silk web. The man handled the big assignment of trap drums was a little dude named Everett Brown Jr. He exemplified versatility on the skins, erecting remarkable structures of rhythm to house this music. The sound of black art, the black saxophone, will always remain in the heads of every urban revolutionary. He has become a living legend. Even as a young instrumentalist, he took the music to new heights. A mighty host of sound wizards always provided a magnificent background for black authors' beautiful solos. Among this assemblage of unbelievable musicians was Alan Hines, Jimmy Woods, Stanley Chico Robinson, Louis Spears, Herbert Baker, the legendary phenomenon of exotic rhythms, the late Leroy Brooks, Roberto Miranda, Latin Hermano, who rolled raunchy rhythms off of his bass as easily as a rabbit can run. The wild lyrical call of Will Cornell's horn still lingers in the ambience of La La Town. Least of all, let us not forget the laughing trombone of the legendary late Lester Robinson, who let everybody in on the secret of good music, saying, say it's Lester. Go the car in reverse and head straight up. Lester's fellow bandmate, the late Guido Sinclair, got the spirit every time he blew his golden sax. The lurid trumpet of Lawrence Butch Boris was given to him personally by the angel Gabriel. Somewhere along the line, African People's Orchestra. They chose the concept of art because of the perilous waters that Africans must travel in these prophetic, apocalyptic times. The oarsmen on this musical ark were without fear, rising up out of the cargo hold of this ark, wanting to hear the eternal yearning sound of brave stratas, radiant tenor saxophone, as his eclectic brother, Ernest Strata, emitted riveting notes of silver from his flute. When Horace needed relief on the ebony and ivory, he would often pass the baton to the intense-browed Nate Morgan, whose nimble fingers caressed the keys with the adroitness of Adam when he first touched Eve. The joint was always jumping when Jesse Sharp jammed on his exquisite saxophone, singing like an eagle soaring in the heavens above the running free. We salute the mean intonations coursing out of the horn of Michael Sessions. Atmospheres like a rocket was musician astronaut Azar Lawrence. Beyond the immediate world of struggle for survival are the lovely melodies of Billy Harris, whose huge sound was larger than his lion heart. Awakener of the masses, Kamal Daoud, whose words always opens our doors of knowledge. Free and unfettered are the novel dimensions revealed in Professor Kathy Roberts' finesse on flute. Soaring into the ethereal realm with the voice of his soul, born from a trumpet, is Steve Smith. Cynthia Hunt, we salute. We salute Gary Myers. We salute Larry Gale. We salute Robert Sims. And one day, a black Hercules came to Earth with a set of African kumkas to energize all kidnapped Africans. His name was Ernest Tojo.
African Orchestra that we have not mentioned.